See the security people supporting the talk. See them. See, talks, they go listen to talks to enter motor. Talks to enter motor. See, talks to enter motor with them. See, the security people.
I'm sad and heartbroken. I don't know where to start from. I'm not the kind of guy that talks about politics, but I can't keep quiet anymore for what is going on back home in Nigeria. I would say, Nigerian government, you guys are a shame to the world for killing your own citizens, sending military to the street to kill unarmed protesters because they are protesting for their rights. It's uncalled for. Today, 20th of October 2020, you people will be remembered in the history as the first government that sent military to the city to start killing their own citizens. I am ashamed of this government. We are tired of you guys, and we can't take this anymore. I'm calling the UK government, calling all those leaders in the world to please see what is going on in Nigeria and help us, help the poor citizens. The government are killing their own citizens. We are calling you guys, the UN, to see to the matters. And I want to call my brothers and sisters back home to remain safe. Be indoors, please don't come out, because these governments, they are killers, and they will keep killing if the world did not talk about this. God bless you all and remain safe. One Nigeria, we move.
See the security people supporting the talk. See them. They go listen to talks to enter motor. See the security people.
From the very beginning, we have continued to emphasize that all ENSA's protests are peaceful, and they have continued to remain peaceful till date. The government has introduced some unscrupulous elements to try and discredit our cause, but it can never work. And once again, we have seen signs of a failed government, a government that has told us that they are unable to perform their functions. They are unable to carry out their duty. Catch these crews. There is a law called the Electoral Act, and section 94, I'll cross check, but there's a particular provision of that law that states that commissioners of police in every single state must deploy adequate security to make sure that there's peace in any form of political rally across the country. Guess what? Lagos State has just imposed a curfew, telling us that they are unable to control the violence. Guess what? The curfew can never be forever. And once you lift this curfew, we are back. And this is my humble suggestion for when we come back out. I suggest we have our designated grounds of protest, so we know that in each state, this is where we're going to. In Lagos State, we report to this place, we report to that place. Even if it's just one place, the more we're together, the harder it is for them to pin anything on us. And we know that once we are here, and this is our designated ground of protest, anybody found anywhere else perpetrating any form of violence must be arrested and brought to book.
Let one of us find out the cause of this. Find out who has the constitutional authority to order soldiers.
Why are you people not coming out to say anything? Why are you people silent?
Why are you not fighting for us?
These people are being killed. Why are you people silent about it? If you kill everybody, why are you going to govern? You are going to govern yourself and the goat and the police that are in power.
Hello?
We can hear you, please.
Okay. I'm not the commander-in-chief.
Are you trying to track us now so that you can track us and come
and kill us, Abi?
Why are you people not saying anything?
You are just being wicked. You are just being wicked.
Are you happy about this? You people are old. Let us have peace of mind. Give us a good government. That's what we want. Are we asking for too much?
Don't you have children too?
Are we asking for too much?
Don't you have children too?
What is all this? Your children will grow up.